Hello there guys, welcome back to the channel and welcome to Survival Russia. It's an awesome day today, it's Saturday, it's overcast, it's like minus 10, feels like spring, super awesome. So today we of course gonna take, surprise, surprise, a look at an outdoors phone. Anyway, I would call it an outdoors phone. You can most likely use it for work and all that good stuff as well, because it's a pretty tough phone. It has some really, really awesome features. And it's also a very, very fast working phone, which is very important to me when I'm using my phone as a GPS unit, right? We're also gonna take a look at what this guy here has in common with this guy here. Believe it or not, they have something in common. So what I think we're gonna do is that we're gonna head over in the tent, because I lit up the oven over there. And it's a little bit nicer light over there, and it's warmer and so on. But this guy also has a thermal imaging camera. Super awesome thermal imaging camera, actually. So I think we're gonna go over there and test it on the oven. And I'll show you a little bit about the phone here. As many of you guys know, I often use my phone as a navigation device and stuff out in the woods. So this is not just a review I'm gonna do, because it's not even a review, it's just my first impressions on this little guy here, because I only got it a few days ago, right? And only managed to get a SIM card in it a few days ago as well. But everything I review and show to you guys is stuff that I use. It's stuff that I choose myself, right? This is made from quality components. It's nothing crappy. I do have what you can say, experience with the funky outdoors phones, which are not so awesome. They couldn't really update, and you had to get a special email account to update them, and blah 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 blah. This is just works just like an ordinary phone. Let's stop the blah blah blah. Let's get over there, take a look at the phone. All right guys, so we're in the tent. It's dripping down. We have the oven running down there. It's nice and when warm in here, or warmer, let's just say it like that. But here we have the phone, AGM Pro G1. Here we have another phone. This is my normal phone. Here we have a size comparison with a normal phone and my hands. We're gonna get the phone here down on the table, and we're gonna take a look at it close up, of course. So for the specs on this phone, there will be links in the description. And there's gonna be a link in a pinned comment, of course, as well. And as I said, this is a phone that I'm gonna use and I'm gonna rely on in the woods for my maps and all that good stuff. One of the things anyway, the awesome thing about this phone here is that at minus 27 C's, this will work for about 24 hours. At minus 30 C's, and that means when the phone is at minus 30 C's, it doesn't mean when you have it in your pocket and you take it out in minus 30 or 27 or 40 for that matter, it, when the phone's core temperature is that cold. So for for minus 27, about one day. For minus 30, about 10 hours. And for minus 40, and it's all centigrade, of course, 60 minutes. So it's a funky, you can see, a little bit interesting how much the performance drops. You can say from 27, it's one day, to 30, it's only 3 degrees more, right? And it's already down on 10 hours. 10 degrees more, it's like the performance is down on, or the battery life is down on 1 hour only. But there's not many phones that's gonna be able to work in minus 40 or minus 30 with a core temperature of minus 30 or 40. That is for dang sure. We're gonna put that to the test at some point, of course. But as I said, this is not a review. This is my first impressions on the phone here. My first impressions are good, contrary to the few other outdoors phones that I have tested and I don't use anymore and have not used beyond testing, let's say it like that. All right, so what does these two guys have in common? I've seen the AGM phone listed as weighing 730 grams, I think, but that is not really the case. It weighs 820. And that is the same weight as a small Makarov pistol. They weigh exactly the same, so you have something to compare with. Here we have the phone. Looks like this. Black screen. Of course, activation button there. Volume button. We have the world's largest mobile phone speaker. I don't know how useful it is. Not for me anyway, I don't care. But it's 3.5 watts. world's largest speaker on a mobile phone or cell phone. We have the fingerprint scanner here for opening the phone. And the fingerprint scanner actually works, and it works pretty steadily. That's super awesome. As I said, this guy here is made out of quality components, so it has an infrared camera, a 20 megapixel infrared camera, and then the main camera is a Sony 48 megapixel camera, which is pretty cool. We also have a dual flashlight in the front here. The phone is running on Qualcomm Snapdragon 480, and it's of course 5G compatible and all that good stuff. But one of the really, really awesome features about this phone is this little guy here, the infrared camera. It's a super awesome infrared camera. And the infrared camera is the fastest infrared thermal imaging camera that you can get for a mobile phone. And that's pretty awesome because it works. It actually works, and it works pretty awesome. I mean, the infrared camera here, that is almost, you know, for me anyway, that is enough just to have this phone. It's an awesome phone. I mean, so far anyway. But I'm gonna make a review on it here a few weeks time when I've been using it enough. I'm gonna show you the infrared thermal imaging camera here in a sec. I can see my oven here. It's super cool. All right, guys. I don't know how this is working, but there's lava sitting, as you can see. There's Mrs. Survivor Russia. Down here we have a computer. You can see in there, it's warming up. And down here we have an oven. A stove. Which is pretty hot. So that's a little bit of playing around with the thermal camera. The thermal camera is a super awesome feature. And I think it's gonna be useful as well for outdoors and survival purposes, debunking how winter shelters work and so on and so forth. All right, guys, so here we have the map function. It is a little bit difficult to show you under these circumstances here, but we'll take a deeper look at it at some point. But you can see we just have the map on a random spot. But if I zoom out, it's pretty fast to update the map, right? That is a really important thing, actually. So here we have my standard phone. You see how slow it works. But it actually works, which is pretty impressive. And pretty weird in some way. Because the problem with this little guy here in the woods can be that when we are offline and we only have the GPS signal and no internet connection and no phone connection whatsoever, only the GPS signal, then this sometimes is just not updating. I don't know why, but that is not awesome. I noticed that this does. I said we're gonna look much more into this phone here and testing it in the woods, and in a few weeks time I'm gonna make a review on it. I have only just familiarized myself with it, so I have not, I don't know all the features and all that good stuff yet. So yeah, the phone is pretty fast, it's pretty awesome, because out in the woods, you want the phone to be able to process these huge maps, these huge offline maps, right? So that's one of the good things about it. The thermal camera, it's gonna be awesome for some survival stuff, some survival science, I think. So guys, I think I've been blah blah blahing enough for this little video here. So if you found the phone interesting, there's going to be links in the description, there's going to be links in the pinned comment and so on. AGM Pro G1, awesome phone so far anyway. We will see how it performs in the long run. So guys, please check the links in the description, please consider supporting the channel and all that good stuff, and until next time, get out and train, get it done, do something awesome, and see you in the next video, guys. Thank you very much for your time on this Saturday.